Hi, Jim Shaw here from Crystal Group. Going to spend a little bit of time today taking a deeper dive into MIL-STD-810, and specifically today we're talking about low temperature or method 502. And 502 is essentially designed to figure out how your equipment or test how your equipment works at lower temperatures. And so what are you looking for when you're doing this test? Why is it imposed on us? So we're looking for embrittlement of materials or gaskets, binding interfaces, broken glass. That's one of the common problems. From the electronics standpoint, there's a whole list of things that happen with COTS electronics and super low temperatures. Any crystal oscillators don't work well. Sometimes the magnetic hysteresis of transformers change their properties. You have startup problems with some of the electronics. There's a whole list of things that you need to be looking for when you're doing low temperature testing. Condensation is another issue, but generally from the electronic standpoint, it's really the performance of the circuitry under those extremes, because a lot of those components change their nominal values as you go down. So it's very important to pick a supplier that uses high quality industrial temperature types of components, and you gotta stick with that. And so that's sort of our philosophy. In the low temperature testing that we do here, there's really three test procedures that we look at. We have a storage procedure, and then we have an operational procedure, and then there's one that we don't really do very often, and that's ease of setup under cold conditions, and that's got to do with Arctic mittens and gloves and things like that, and that's relevant usually from the design standpoint of mill circular connectors, but not so much in terms of the testing that we do here. So as a general rule, we'll take a look at either minus 55 or minus 65 as a temperature that we'll test to in the low temperature storage realm. And then we also look at operation, and so we'll go down to minus 40 for operational testing. And so there are some things that you have to do to modify COTS equipment to make it perform in those levels. And so that's one of the things that we do here at Crystal Group that's pretty unique, and a lot of our competitors aren't able or willing to do that kind of thing. So it sets us apart a little bit from that standpoint. But that's the kind of testing that you see in Method 502. There are other specifications out there, like a DO160, that do something very similar to that. But in effect, we follow, for the most part, MIL-STD 810 and use this Method 502 for the low temperature testing. That's all I've got today. Thanks a lot.
Join us next time for another shiny object at Crystal Group.